Hello, so we are 000, so we just flipped the coin to know which one was the lucky to speak in front of all of you and which one needs to work and play with the machines. So we are basically focused on percussion and distortion devices, so it was intentionally this kind of rough sounds, and it was fully performed in our system that is a complete analog, this percussion and distortion. And we started like quite recently, like in August 2015, to design like more the board. So we have been in the last 10 years making workshops worldwide and developing the modules. And recently we formed this kind of new collective to put together all these tools. So what we are doing is basically something that we was missing like a lot, that it was like a fully analog drum machine where you can just have like different modules. So the system is divided on different kind of single modules. Like the format is called Eurorack, so like the standard, and basically shares like the way of powering and the way of the voltage that it uses. And through this system, you can just go creating, like expanding your, let's say, your universe, your space to play. So for us, this is intended more or less like as an art project. So we have seen like wonderful kind of projects today, and we are kind of a bit more primitive into the design. But we see it like a research to how to get really like from two art students. So my background is lithography and engraving. Pablo is a painter that now makes watercolors, but we work fully into the art field. So we just start to get into production, into resourcing, into manufacture, like kind of different parts to have like everything done as we would like to use it. So this is kind of some pictures of the system, like of the previous system. So we have split like the different voices of the system, and like say like from the bass drum, like the toms, the hi-hats, the snare. So, and then when we fully develop the back part, let's say the brain from the system, we start to get into how to work with the interface. So where to place the components, how to start to design our own knobs, our own laser engrave buttons with the aesthetics and with the graphics that we were learning from the university times. So basically we are now like small players, as the talk like before, and we come like from the arts, so we really are working into the arts field, and this is like a parallel kind of project. So we are somehow developing every modules for the needs, like for the bands that we have together, for the collective, for the mastering equipment that we have been doing. And since August 2015 is when we start to give this kind of shape and the name to the project. So really everything starts in our house, so let's say in the lab. But we have like, nowadays Pablo works in Santander in the north of Spain, I'm working in Leipzig, so we work a lot through the internet and we get some kind of pretty nice miscommunications. But as we really like what we are doing, suddenly we get to some kind of interesting results of some ideas that we talk and we discuss, and then the outcome that it comes. So basically we start to make this kind of concept more as an artistic kind of research. So we start to work with some kind of principles that we find it interesting for us as a band, and then start to adapt to these electronics. So this was the first official prototype from the bass drum. And after doing with it, we learned like a lot. We were influenced, so when normally, or all of us, we have learned like through copying, no? We learn how to talk. We learn how to express all other ideas through copy and see how other people do. And then after this, we start to, let's say, digest all the things we have learned, take apart all the things that we thought it was not interesting, and then adding something new to the system itself. So we start with some kind of schematics from the 60s that it were totally reliable, or that we like it because we were using also some kind of these machines. And then opening it up, start to understand all the circuit, start to experiment, and then make it kind of the outcome. So after having like the bass drum, that when you are, let's say, into electronic music or electroacoustic music, is like kind of what drives all the rhythm. we start to make a kind of other modules. So in this case was the snore, and after doing this it was interesting because it's basically similar to the other design but adding some kind of noise. So we were kind of implementing some kind of analog ways to do noise, like from pink noise or white noise or different kind of weird noises, and then have some kind of percussions that they were kind of this stuff. So then we thought it was too clean, the sound, and then we wanted like a bit of distortion, so our background came from punk music, like from the north of Spain, from then to experimental, industrial noise. So then we start to develop some kind of modules to take all the clean signal that was outcoming and basically destroying it as much as possible, to take all the grain, all the harmonics and their upper kind of harmonics or different kind of response to the first input. So also we were kind of doing some different filters. Like this was the first digital module that we have built that basically is like an interface with this interface that has like an input, like an output, like way to interact with real world and real machines that Hannes Waldschutz, that is in the middle of this room, was helping us because our node of coding is good enough to play with Super Collider or with other kind of pure data or like a bit with Arduino, but not stable enough to have something like is like really professional, that it was what we was interested. So not to have like a project that half works, to finish with a project that people could use it, could adapt it, but also that is fully functional in terms of making a performance or rely or to play like in public. After, of course, all these tests, we start to have some, because for us was interesting also to document what's the process when two, let's say, normal people that didn't get any kind of, or we learned by ourselves all the electronics, we were not, of course, engineers, we were not connected to all this kind of market, they start to get into different websites to resource the electronics, to produce the boards, and then we tried in the beginning to make the boards in Europe, and with all the problems that this comes in terms of prices, of costs, of quality, and then now we have find like kind of better suppliers where we could have like much more defined like milling machines to cut, or much more defined kind of components that they are kind of easy to solder. So right now we are also like experimenting with different kind of layers that the printed circuit board offers. So with the any process to make the gold, with the translucent part, so you see here some orange LEDs that they are in the back, so you can have like the light passing through the panel, so kind of making it more durable. So in case you are playing and you are like expressing yourself like with the instruments, they just don't crack or they don't break. So this is kind of some kind of close photos of how the precision of the PCBs on making them. And then we were starting to get fascinated by this black matte and gold, and then we get totally deep into this. So basically, like we were going to make the presentation a bit longer, but we need now to go to the sound check. So we base our designs of the percussion in the Twin T oscillator. And this is basically like kind of like an oscillator, quite easy to excite, so you can make all the percussion. So you can add like an envelope, you can add a BCA, and then when we started to learn like about the schematics, it was really quite hard to fully understand what was behind. So also one important part of the project that I think also what we are here is trying to split like the all the schematics, now here you can see it so clear, but also it's also in our website, like try to express all the little parts, so the next one that comes behind us could make it even better. So can adapt all these parts, can take the things that they like to use it, let's say like a stable trigger or like an accent module, and they could extract these parts using it in another system. So this was also what some people also in some forums are quite confused about our modules, and they say, there was a sentence in Red Edit that the project seems a bit fishy somehow because they could not understand how cheap could be the modules or why we were publishing. So you create also some kind of nice dialogues between the community, between some kind of other manufacturers. So the idea is to try to document everything to people could reproduce as easy as possible with this kind of modern techniques and all these kind of fab labs and etching processes. So Then we started to get like more into industrial production, and then we thought, why not designing like our buttons, and why not have them like the perfect height, the black, the orange LEDs. So we start to collaborate with different kind of companies. In this case was with Wellbuyin, that they were super open to collaborate, let's say, with artists to make some kind of limits from their own machines and how to laser cut some kind of buttons and some kind of different of the products they offer. So then suddenly, after some months, we received the first unit, and it was kind of having this kind of miniature buttons that also could be like RGB, that are pressed or they are pushed also, and they can offer like the aesthetics and the functionality for our designs. So every time we start to design some kind of new function in the module, it's quite interesting when you are working with a computer with all the CAD software and you see everything like magnified in big scale, and then you suddenly receive the tiny part perfectly kind of produced. So this was kind of the first like big amount of boards that we ordered. And then like again, so when you're working with a computer, this will be like the full range of all the panel that we order, and then like with all the graphics and all the layers, and it was kind of suddenly receiving like a packet and sending it like a photo or like a talk through online with Pablo to say like, fuck, finally it's kind of something you can just touch. So we were starting to play also with these concepts right now, and then we can make them kind of more standalone. So right now, after working with all these models, we have started to sophisticate much more the designs and to start to work with much complex synthesis to making all these different modules. So the last functional module is this one kind of Toms. We call it like Toms of Finland, related to the great comics that it was there. So it was kind of adapting kind of some kind of FM synthesis and then translating this to percussion. So also right now you have like all this kind of precision FM synthesis in the oscillator with the weirdness of with our ideas to have like kind of longer decays to make drones and to make some have more versatile modules. So also like in the Fab Labs right now, so like from in Leipzig or in Media Lab Prado or in Angar, we have been also like collaborating in Spain with them, and we were kind of sketching our ideas. So it was quite interesting to before talking with other big companies, making all these kind of prototypes and documenting even like the new housings that we are doing like in aluminium and all these kind of different projects. So the idea of all these tools is, as it was in the beginning, is because we have like a band together since many years, and then we started to think first we need something more easy to carry with us, because we had like a big setup of machines that they look nice in the studio, but it's impossible to travel with them. And then we start to scale it down to some kind of fundamentals. So then we are basically doing some kind of industrial or kind of more modern kind of industrial mixed with some kind of repetitive patterns. And then normally what we use is kind of like huge visuals, like kind of as big as possible kind of projectors, 10,000 lumens or 5,000 lumens like projectors, and kind of filling up with the space with the black and white visuals from our video synthesizers and with the sound from our system. So nowadays we can fully perform with the system that we have developed, that also has made us also get much deeper into what's performing and how to perform with our ideas. Many of these tests came from this kind of big black boxes that we were building like before, and it was kind of like a lot of tests that we were taking like some ideas, like just only from recording from all radios, from sounds of like crystals breaking, or to like when you go through an empty industry, this kind of reverberations or standing waves that you get. So we started with this kind of concepts, and now we try to implement in all these kind of boards. So this is the first presentation, and we need to go to the sound check. So you are all welcome to come later for the performance. And this is not intended as a company kind of product that we are doing, because what we really will be interesting is like right now, Pablo and me started, Hannes is collaborating also a lot, and we have other kind of artists and other kind of people that are kind of getting into the project and extracting what they want from it or modifying. So we are basically doing like workshops like worldwide about how to create these machines and how to adapt to their needs. So feel free to go to the website and get like the information that you will like from there. So thank you very much.
Voy quitando.